The coronavirus may not be as big a health threat anymore, at least for vaccinated people, but new research shows the pandemic will likely affect our well-being for years to come.
Denver 7's Nicole Brady joins us now. Nicole, Colorado researchers call it an astounding drop in our life expectancy.
Yeah, life expectancy in the U.S. dropped last year by an average of 2 years. It doesn't sound like a lot, but we're talking about an average here. And this was actually the sharpest decline in U.S. life expectancy since World War II. And even more concerning, the U.S. fell a lot more than other wealthy countries.
The overall loss of life was astoundingly high in the United States. Unlike other countries, it was far more concentrated at younger ages than in other high-income countries, and it fell very strongly across race ethnic lines in arguably a very predictable way.
So I spoke to one of the CU Boulder researchers involved in this study. It found that life expectancy fell to under 80 years old for women in 2020 and down to 74 years old for men. Both of those about a 2-year drop from what the life expectancy was in 2010. Now, if you compare this to peer countries, some of those countries actually saw a gain in life expectancy of 1 year over the past decade, even with the COVID pandemic factored in. And then it's even worse for people of color. Black women lost 4 years of life expectancy. Black men's life expectancy fell to under 68 for the first time since the 1990s. And Hispanic populations also saw a decline of about 4 years as well. Now, Masters told me that the real concern is that U.S. life expectancy was already struggling in recent years because of things like obesity and cardiovascular disease. And factors like that are exactly what made the U.S. more vulnerable to the coronavirus.
We should not interpret the events of COVID-19 just within the time frame of 2020. Again, the trajectory that we were on long term is not a great one.
Yeah, and I always ask for positive takeaways when I do interviews on studies. And unfortunately, there really is no positive in this one. Masters said if we don't address these persistent health issues, we will likely be more vulnerable if there's another pandemic or another threat to our health in the future. He does not see life expectancy going up in the near future. Brian.
Wow. Okay. Thank you, Nicole.